two allotropes, one which is graphite and the other one is diamond. Both the allotropes will have different physical properties. An example which we can take over here is that graphite, it is a good conductor of electricity, it is soft, whereas when we are talking of diamond, diamond is very very hard and it is a bad conductor of electricity. So the allotropes, they have different structures and they have different properties. The shapes and the characteristic properties of graphite and diamond we will study in the next section. Then the next one, that is our metallic solids. The metallic solids have constituent particles as metals, or we can also say that the constituent particles are electrons and kernels. Electrons are negatively charged, whereas kernels which are positively charged, so they have special forces of attraction between them, and these special forces of attraction, they are known as metallic bonds. They are known as metallic bonds. All the metals, they come under this category. All the metals, they come under this category, like copper, sodium, aluminium, silver, etc. Right? So this is the entire classification based on the type of constituent particles. Let's quickly take a recap. Molecular solids, the constant particles, they are going to be molecules with three different forces of attraction. If we have a non-polar molecule, the forces of attraction is London forces. If we have a polar molecule, the forces of attraction is dipole-dipole interactions. And if we have hydrogen bonded molecules, the forces of attraction, that is going to be a hydrogen bond, which is a bond between hydrogen and a highly electronegative atom. Right? Then we go to ionic solids. The constant particles is ions over here. They have electrostatic forces of attraction, or they are also known as ionic bonds. These are one of the strongest bonds which are present amongst all. Examples are NaCl, KCl, MgCl2. All the ionic substances, they come under this category. The third is your covalent solids. The covalent solids have atoms as their constituent particles, or jo bonds hai uske beech mein, they are the covalent bonds. An example is carbon, the two electrodes of carbon, graphite and diamond. And then we come to metallic solid. Metallic solid have negatively charged electrons in a sea of positively charged kernels, and they have special kind of bonds between them which are known as metallic bonds. All the metals, they come under this category. So this is our first section of our chapter 1. You've already done the difference between the structures of the two allotropes of carbon, that is diamond and graphite. So we'll quickly just memorize what it is. Allotropes of carbon. By allotropes we mean two different structural forms of the same element. Structural forms of the same element. We are going to discuss two allotropes of carbon over here. The first one is diamond, and the second one is graphite. Diamond and graphite. Now, in case of diamond, each carbon atom is covalently bonded to four other carbon atoms. So if you look at the structure, carbon atom 1, it is already bonded to 1, 2, 3, 4, right? Similarly, if you are looking at this carbon atom, already bonded to 2, 3 and 4. So this carbon atom is already bonded to 2. So this is how your structure of diamond that is going to be. The hybridization in case of diamond, it is sp3. As a result of its three-dimensional network, diamond that is the hardest substance known. Whereas when we are talking of graphite, graphite has a sheet-like structure. It has a sheet-like structure, or we can also call it a layer structure, where both the layers they are bonded by van der Waals forces of attraction. So when we are looking at the structure of graphite, let's see, this is our layer 1, right? And this is the second layer. Solids, that is the classification of
solids.